as you can see, a southpaw, so he leads with his right hand, and that means that that right eye is more exposed than the left. Means that he'll have more problems getting hit with it, but also it's, that's what he's seeing Leone with, that eye predominantly. So all sorts of problems for the Japanese fighter, as Leone once again forces the action to the ground.
Here Leone's brother saying to suck him away from the cage. He wants him to use that fence to pull his body off. When you have your opponent against the cage like that, you want his back flat on the canvas to really maximize the leverage. Leone's got one hook in now, working on the back here of Kojima. That looks like Kojima's eyes red. He might have got poked in the eye.
Yeah, he's certainly having trouble around that area of the face, isn't he? Also holding a full-fledged conversation with his corner by the looks of things.
Trying to work that second hook in. There it is. This is a bad position for Kojima to be in. Andrew's going to probably look to go to a body lock figure four on his legs. See the strikes landed in this round, primarily up through this point of the fight. 37 strikes for Andrew Leone. Kojima, 10 strikes.
Andrew, want to finish?
There's that figure four body lock we talked about. That makes it very hard for your opponent to move, and it takes a lot of the wind out of you, too. It's a very, very effective way of holding back control. The only downside of that is that you really can't hit any submissions, like arm bars and things, or you can't maneuver without moving your legs out of that position. But if you just want to look at the choke, that figure four body lock, and then protecting that foot underneath your opponent's knee, like Andrew's doing with his right leg there, is absolutely money.
I think you can hear Leone's corner wanting Leone to put Kojima on his front.
Yeah, he wants him to have Kojima on his belly so that Andrew has the benefit of not only the figure four and the back control, but the added benefit of gravity to throw some punches.
Oh, well switched by Kojima. Suddenly just changed it up, didn't he, and spun round. Slippery bodies now, making it difficult for both men, but that worked to Kojima's advantage.
Keep walking,
2 minutes and 20 seconds left in this contest.
Now, let's go. 2 minutes hard, let's go. Here we go again. Work your way up, work up.
Kojima's doing the right thing. He's pushing on the back of Andrew Leone's head, trying to get his head off of him. That's the first thing you want to do when a wrestler is in deep like that, because wherever your head goes, your body's going to go. Push that head away and try to create some space. And Kojima wants to use his back there to walk up the cage and stand up.
Oh, knee to the head there with that. This is just intense, isn't it? Relentless pressure that Leone puts on his opponent.
I think at this point, Kojima's going to need a Hail Mary submission for some massive damage being done here, because Kojima has taken more of the damage. The general ring control has been Leone's dictation of where the fight takes place. So I think the striking has probably been about equal standing up. What we saw there, that the number of strikes landed, 37 to 10, is going to put Andrew ahead so far through the fight. Almost fully through, good pass in the start position.
He's okay. He's on short elbows now. Use that left elbow. Push it in there now.
That's
it. Let's go, crucifix, Andrew. Slide that down. That's
plenty of rolling up.
Final 30 seconds of this third round, this third and final round. It's been all Leone in terms of attacking pressure. Kojima will be absolutely exhausted having to defend this off for the better part of the entire contest.
It's not only extremely physically exhausting, but it's mentally just a pain in the butt. You've got a guy who's just constantly grinding on top and you can't get him off. Andrew Leone looking for an armbar here. Might be a little late.
He's gonna run out of time. time. It's all over. What a contest that was. Leone thinks he's won. I must say I do as well.
I can't see a situation here where Andrew Leone doesn't get the nod from our judges. This is a beautiful back position. You see Andrew, and then when he opened up his legs and switched that figure four, Kojima felt that there was a little space there and spun right into it. Then Andrew Leone threw a body block and a nice takedown. That was really the story of this fight. Andrew Leone's takedowns kind of dominated and used that American wrestling.
That was the story of the fight. The story of the matchup was about which one of these two could progress to a possible fight for the title. But you wonder, even if Leone wins this, whether not making weight is going to hamper that prospect for him.
Well, here's the crazy thing, right? Leone can't fight for a title because he's actually never had a bout in
that
weight class.
Yes.
Legitimately, you can't fight for. He's had two bouts that have both been catchweight. So, on paper, yes, he
right
should
point.
Probably fight for a title soon. But both of his fights being at a catchweight, he hasn't missed weight twice.
Great point.
So he hasn't fought in this division.
Anyway, we're assuming he's won. Confirmation is about to come. Anthony Zuntal.
Ladies and gentlemen, after three rounds, we go to the judges' scorecards, and all three judges see it for your winner via unanimous decision. From the red corner, Andrew Leone!
Congratulations, Andrew Leone. Shinichi Kojima looked absolutely sick when that decision was announced. He made weight, Leone did. He still applauded the man who won the contest, so great sportsmanship from the Japanese fighter.